So we know that fitness plays a huge part in being a good squash player. So I'm going to run through some of the videos that I'm going to do. Number one is court sprints. Court sprints is number one because if you ask any top squash player about improving your fitness, they'll all probably say just do court sprints. So we'll do a video on when you should do them, how you should do them, how many sets you should do, how often, kind of stuff like that. So that's number one. Number two, ghosting. And there's a huge variety in different ways that you can move around the court and different scenarios that you can do. So we'll do a video on ghosting. Number three is running. Sometimes you might not be able to get on the court. So we're gonna run through some of the different ways that you can run. So this doesn't mean just, going for a 30-minute run. It's all about keeping the intensity up and also stuff like 400-meter sprints and whatnot. Number four, last but not least, is speed and agility. And this is actually a really important one that gets missed a lot by a lot of players. And you'll notice that there's some top players out there that are really quick and they're really agile around the court. And this comes down to their speed and agility. And you notice like sometimes they're way out of the rally, but they still seem to win it just by getting the ball back. And sometimes you just need to keep in the rally to put your opponent under pressure. So this is a really good one. And it also helps with your footwork around the ball. So getting your feet in the right place, because remember, footwork affects technique, because if your feet aren't in the right place, too far away from the ball or too close to the ball, then this really does affect your technique. So check out the speed and agility video. And don't forget to subscribe.